So now, take a look, shall we?
If you don't listen, we'll smack you!
Good morning, sir. Mind telling us what you're all doing here?
Nothing at all. We're just going to work with the councillors when they go in.
And you are?
Sonny Williams, Cockcroft Residents Association, Attlee Block. We've been waiting 2.5 years to be re-housed, we have.
Cockcroft Estate. Thought I recognised some of the faces.
Yeah,
and after railings have fallen off as well.
Stop it, for kids, let alone kids.
And it stinks. Curry and chapatis, night and day. Kick them out.
Quite enough of that, thank you, sir.
We're not doing anything wrong, it's a public paving, you know, sir. So why don't you just leave us alone?
It's a demonstration, sir. You can only go ahead if you're not causing an obstruction. And if the police have no objection.
And do you?
That's not up to me, sir.
Just customer from the Cockcroft Estate.
Yeah, Oscar 595 receiving.
Go ahead, Tony.
I've got about a dozen residents off the Cockcroft Estate, Sarge, outside the town hall. They want to give the councillors an ear bashing about the state of their flats.
Can't say I blame them.
It depends who they are. Someone that estate you wouldn't want on the street if the house was on fire.
Who exactly are they, Tony? Do you recognise anyone?
Just residents, Sarge. I know a few of them. Question is, do we move them on or let them stay here?
Well, you can see the situation, Tony. We can't. Are they causing an obstruction?
Well, not really, Sarge. But Danny Hargood's here with some mates, and he's a piece of trash if ever there was one.
I'll speak to Mr. Munro. Keep us posted, Tony.
The meeting should finish about 12, Marion, but don't expect me back till after lunch.
Right, sir.
Not much point in going to area if you don't have lunch, is there?
No. You off, sir?
Yes, I'm just off to a meeting, but don't expect me back too soon, Philip. Unless it's a matter of life or death.
Yes, sir, I'll hold the fort. I want to continue my familiarisation process today, sir, with air relief.
I thought you'd be familiar enough with them by now.
Only a dozen of them?
Yeah, residents of the Cockcroft. They're supposed to have been rehoused by now, sir.
Right.
Problem is, there's people like Danny Hargood amongst them, mouthing off about Asian residents as usual, I should think.
It would have to be the Cockcroft, wouldn't it? If we don't let them protest, it'll set back relations even further.
Yeah, and if we do, we could end up with a fight on the town hall steps, sir.
Right. So, I think I'll run it by Mr. Cato.
Right.
I'm going to have a word.
You're all right, look, do us a favour. Take your battery out so that one can't hear me.
Some friends of Danny Hargood have just turned up right on cue.
Any name?
Polly's having a word with them now. I think one of them's Derek Crew. He's got some skinhead mates with him.
Now, you must have missed the councillors, and that's all there is to it.
Oh, we only want to have a word with them.
Just to say hello.
It's private property, so stay right here.
Shut up. 595 from Sierra Oscar.
Yeah, go ahead, Kat.
Reg thinks Derek Crew's part of the Britannia Party, a sort of race hate activist. Got a brother. He had him for racial attacks in 89.
Yeah, that fits.
Oh, yeah, Tony, I've just heard from the council. Apparently it's a planning meeting they're having. They've just put it back an hour.
Terrific.
Can't you get rid of them?
Look, we don't want any trouble.
Neither do we. But unfortunately, they live on the same estate, so they've got as much right to protest as anyone else for the time being.
I've got no axe to grind against the Cockcroft Estate. Why not let them go ahead?
The point is, sir, known troublemakers have attached themselves to a group of protesters.
So you said. Can't we handle it?
I know Hollis has spoken to the town hall, sir, and they have no objections to the protest. But if we give these people an inch...
You should hear yourself, Andrew. Known troublemakers, difficult estate. You've got about as much of an open mind as they have.
Sir?
If I give you an inch, Andrew, you'd be running antagonised residents off the streets and digging your own grave on the Cockcroft in the process. Why not just show them all we can handle it?
You mean you're happy for people like that? Racist, to be demonstrating outside the town hall?
Demonstration? You've just told me it was about 3 men and a dog.
15 now, sir.
Besides, I thought you said it was about rehousing, not race.
Some of them very unpleasant characters, sir, right outside the town hall. I can't assess the situation fully till I've had a look at it.
So look at it, Andrew. It's no wonder they hate Sunhill coppers, if you don't even let them have a yell about the condition of their estate.
So this protest is to go ahead then, sir, with your approval?
Yes, Andrew. With my approval. And it's going to pass off peacefully, isn't it? Without arrests. Without arrests, Andrew. Those are my orders.
I mean, what is Cato playing at? Letting thugs like that demonstrate on the street and then telling us to treat them with kid gloves?
Well, you're not getting it, are you, Barry?
Get him what?
Well, Cato's tough, but who do you think's going to be dealing with this lot?
Well, Tony, Polly, us.
Us, exactly. It's our relief that gets the tough treatment. While Brownlow's away, Cato gets to show off how he can run a perfect little demo. No arrests. And we're the ones that get dumped on.
I've sent Dave and Barry down in the van, Cath. I'm afraid we're going to be letting this demonstration continue peaceably, whatever.
What?
Mr. Cato believes it would be a positive step forward in our relations with the Cockcroft.
Oh, so letting Derek Crew have a pop at us is going to help the residents?
I didn't say that, Reg. But if that's how Mr. Cato wants it handled, then that's how it'll be handled.
Yes?
Sir, Mr. Munro suggested that I bring this up to you, so you can hear what's going on.
Did he now?
Had the council on, sir. The meeting's about to start. But the council has been told to go in round the back.
OK, Reg, I'm on my way out there.
What's going on, sir?
Cockcroft residents protesting outside the town hall about their wait for rehousing.
Are we going to let them?
We are. Mr. Cato wishes us to handle it without incident.
I bet he does.
By the way, I'd like a word with you sometime today, John.
Yes, sir, Mr. Munro said. Perhaps when things quieten down a bit.
Give it half an hour. Let them do some shouting. Sloppy policing to overreact.
With respect, sir, these things are very difficult to judge unless you're actually there. Talk to the people.
I know my job, thanks, John. And I do considerably better when I don't listen to a load of noise and prejudice. But now I'll know as much as you do, won't I?
Assistance required! Car is being attacked!
Occupants, Asian, crew and the others trying to get at them!
Back up on the way, Polly. ETA 3 minutes.
Ambulance, please, Sarge. At least two injured.
Sierra Oscar 1, ETA 1 minute.
Message received. What's happening, Barry?
Polly's got Danny Hargood.
What's going on?
Tony's got crew.
I know as much as you do, sir.
Well, they just started on a car that stopped outside, sir, with two Asians in it.
I mean, what are we doing about it?
Trying to contain it. It's still happening, sir.
All units from Sierra Oscar 5-4, backup is on its way. Do not aggravate situation. Repeat, do not aggravate situation.
They did the car in, sir. Kicked in the windscreen. Polly had to stop Argo when he started on Dave Quinnan.
Fine, Barry, but don't aggravate the situation. Avoid arrests.
Page has arrested Hargood, sir, and I've arrested crew. We're getting him in the van now. Over.
Stamp. 595 from Sierra Oscar 5-4. Report my signals immediately.
He's probably having trouble with his PR, sir.
595. 469.
All units near the town hall, report signals. Sierra Oscar, over.
Sierra Oscar from Sierra Oscar 1. Clear R5, and I'm pulling up at the town hall now. The situation looks as previously described.
Sierra Oscar 1 from Sierra Oscar 5-4. Where's Stamp and Page?
Can't see them, sir. Probably in the van now. Some skinheads are around it. We're going to need everyone available just to damp this down for a bit. Over.
If people are banging on the van, sir, Stamp and Page may be unable to hear.
They heard me perfectly well before. So just tell them I'll be waiting for them to have a quiet word about following orders, right?
Yes, sir.
He expects us to get smacked for the sake of his peaceful demo.
Sergeant Cryer.
He's in there, sir.
Morning, sir.
Stamp and Page are bringing in two prisoners from the town hall protest. I'd like them processed and released as soon as possible, OK?
Right, sir. Any particular reason?
I'm making sure a protest concludes peacefully, Bob. And I'd like your assistance, please.
Fine, sir. With respect, my job is care and control of prisoners. If they've been charged, then yes, we could be talking about getting them out. But since they're only under arrest, there's nothing I can do at the moment. It's Tony and Polly you want to be talking to.
Don't worry. I intend to.
Hold on a minute, John. I'm sorry about your demonstration, Mr. Williams.
You're sorry?
The situation is under control now, John. Mr. Williams and most of the other residents are going home in disgust.
Their names are Verner and Singh, sir. Car belongs to Verner. Couldn't get much else out of them. Paramedics are dealing with the cuts.
Go with them down to St Hugh's then, Barry. Make sure they're willing to make a statement. We don't want Crewe and his pal wriggling out of this one.
Yes, sir.
All quiet now. Mr Cato should be pleased.
Message received.
I hope so.
I shouldn't think you will be.
What?
Pleased. The rest of the skinheads are headed here now. They want Crewe and I'll get back.
Give it a rest, will ya?
Here we go, laughing boy.
You're gonna regret this.
You must be joking.
It's a bit airy in there this morning.
Yeah, so I've heard. It's been like the grave in the front office.
Oh, was it? You had a fun really, Sergeant.
Yeah.
Do us all a favour, will you? Get these two charged as quick as you can.
Sergeant.
There you go.
Stamp, page, a word, please.
Follow my lead.
Do you mind telling me why you disobeyed orders?
Orders, sir?
I specifically said the protest was to be kept calm and controlled.
Oh, yes, sir. I remember that.
So why have you got two protesters in the custody suite?
We didn't arrest them for protesting, sir. I arrested Crewe because he attacked two Asian men in a car.
And I arrested Hargood because he started on Dave Quinnan, sir, after he smashed the car's window.
But just how did you let things get to that state in the first place?
We didn't, sir.
Well, someone did! And since I now have a gang of Crewe's mates descending on Sunhill...
And very wound up they are too, sir. We can all vouch for that.
Do you think I've just fallen off a Christmas tree stamp?
We had to arrest them, sir. After keeping a low profile, as requested.
I tried to talk to you of your PRs.
Well, you didn't hear that, sir. There must have been a problem. And we had to act when Crewe and Hargood attacked a car.
Very conveniently.
No, sir. It was after a great deal of provocation and my recommendation that the protest shouldn't be allowed to happen in the first place. I felt that helping a victim and arresting his assailant was more important than having a demo, sir.
Don't push it, Stamp. I want them out of here as soon as possible, preferably before their mates arrive on our doorstep.
Yes, sir. But there might be one problem with that.
Oh, yes.
The owners and occupiers of the car, a Mr. Werner and Singh, wish to press charges for criminal damage and actual bodily harm.
And just how do you know that?
Barry's with them, sir, at St. Hugh's. And they are most insistent.
Yeah, I bet they are.
Mr. Werner and Mr. Singh are being seen now, Cass. Nothing too major. I'll bring them back to the Nick to make a statement as soon as I can.
Good. I think Mr. Cato will be waiting for him, amongst others.
Let's demonstrate. And now he's standing there telling us we overreacted, when you and I both know that Crewe and Hargood could have easily half-killed those blokes.
But Cato did say no arrests, and we can't hold Crewe and Hargood without a statement from the blokes they've attacked.
Then we'll just have to make sure that Werner and Singh are willing to give evidence, won't we?
Let me know the moment the occupants of that car arrive, please, Andrew.
Yes, sir.
And then I want Crewe and Hargood out of here and back on the Cockcroft where they belong, with the rest of the scum.
Yes, sir.
Sir, Crewe's brother Billy and the other youths are in the front office now.
Then I suggest you get them out of it.
Mr. Cato?
Yes?
That was the DAC's office. Mr. Brownlow's meeting was cancelled and he left there about 20 minutes ago.
Thank you.
I'll see to the front office.
Don't bother, I'll see to it myself.
I've tried, sir, but they won't pay any attention to me.
That's what precisely have you tried?
Tell them to stop making noise or they'll be ejected. Tell them to stop drinking on the premises.
We'll see about that.
As if they think they can get away with murder, sir.
Chief Inspector Cato! Oh. I am Chief Inspector Cato in charge of operations at Sunhill. Your friends Crewe and Hargood are presently under arrest, but will probably be released shortly. In the meantime...
What, mate?
Since you have no business here, you can wait outside. Do I make myself understood?
Yeah, well, I'm Billy Crewe, Derek's brother. And if you, Kojak, or any other of your filth, lay one finger on him.
What? In the first place, none of my officers would lay a finger on your brother. And in the second place, you're very welcome to try and lay one on me, because smacking you in the mouth would just about make my day.
Philip?
These young gentlemen are just leaving, sir.
How long are we going to be in here?
We're waiting to see what the damage is to Mr. Werner and Mr. Singh before we know what we can charge you with. In the meantime...
I told you. They got what they deserved.
How do you reckon that?
They look after their own. The Asians get moved out of Cockcroft before us lot. So the people whose country this is are stuck in that rat trap.
So taking it out on a couple of innocent people makes it okay, even if it was true?
Innocent?
People sitting in their car doing you no harm?
Oh, leave it out. It's him that's doing it. Singh.
You know them, do you?
Well, of course. Sing's our counsellor.
Tony!
There's no sign of the car's occupants yet, Sergeant.
Yeah, well, I think the playing field's been changed somewhat in your favour.
How's that?
Your car's occupants? The Asians in the Albania that were assaulted? One of them's a counsellor for the Cockcroft.
You're joking.
Yeah, I wish I was. The name's Singh, apparently.
But Cato's upstairs with Brownlow. Probably explaining how he wants to get Crewe and Hargood out of here as fast as possible.
Yeah, it should be interesting. I think you ought to go and tell him.
Nah. You're a spoil sport, Sarge.
You're going to get Crewe and Hargood released?
Yes, sir. As soon as I can. I don't think we want to aggravate the Cockcroft residents any more than we have done. I tried to get A-Reef to handle it gently, but they just turned a simple protest into a flashpoint.
Simple protest?
That's what it was, yes, sir. About delays in rehousing. That's why I let it proceed. Unfortunately, Crewe and Hargood and the other youth hijacked it.
Oh, why were they allowed to join in?
Well, I left Stamp and Page, sir, and the others, to contain the situation. Only 15 people, after all.
I see. So you agreed to some perfectly peaceable residents having a protest, it was hijacked, and then some of A-Relief let it get out of hand.
Yes, sir, that's about the size of it. But I'll soon have it sorted, don't you worry.
Good. Well, I expect you'll be having a word with Stamp and Page about all this. Extend your familiarisation beyond the sergeants.
Yes, sir.
I had to bring them a back way. Derek's brother and his mates are camped outside the front door.
Yeah, so I heard.
But why do you have to do this now? We just want to go home.
Yes, I'm sorry, sir. I know that, but we have two suspects in custody, so we need your statements.
Crewe and Hargood, you have them here?
Yes, sir. That's why their friends are outside.
I see. Do you know what this is really all about, Mr. Stamp?
Sarge. Yes, sir.
It's gone on long enough, Bob. I want Crewe and Hargood sorted out now. Where's Stamp and Page?
We are sorting them, sir. Stamp's interviewing the victims now.
So they're here. Going to press charges?
Well, I assume so, sir. And looking at them, I think we can go for ABH. I imagine I'm going to charge Crewe and Hargood any minute now.
Then bailing them, I presume.
Sir? Derek Crewe has got a list of form as long as your arm. And now he's badly injured one of our local councillors.
One of our what?
I'm sorry, but one of the two victims is a councillor responsible for the Cockcroft, a Mr. Singh.
I was told they were just some Asians passing by.
Well, Mr. Verner and Mr. Singh were passing by on their way to a meeting in Mr. Verner's car. They didn't get the message about using the back entrance.
But why wasn't I told this?
We didn't know it.
I've just spent the last hour trying to get rid of Crewe and Hargood to restore the peace.
I see. Well, I guess they'll probably qualify for bail.
I don't want to give them bail!
But a minute ago you
said... That was then, Bob. What's a Cockcroft going to think if we go easy on Crewe and Hargood after they beat seven shades out of one of their councillors?
I wouldn't like to say so.
Neither would I. Charge them with everything you can, then send Stamp and Page to see me. I'd have explained all this to Mr. Brownlow.
They're just so stupid, you know. Derek Crewe and his movement.
I'll second that.
But you see, Mr. Stamp, our council operates a policy to move the families with most children out of Attlee Block first. That's why it appears the Asians are jumping the queue.
I see.
Since it started after I was elected, Derek Crewe and his organisation have got it into their head that it's my doing, that because I'm Asian, I'm pulling strings.
Haven't you told him?
Of course I have. I told him when he asked at a meeting, but that just made him worse. It's our fault for having such large families.
What I don't understand is how come you let them demonstrate about it?
It wasn't my idea to let the protest go ahead, Mr. Verner. But if you'll just make a statement, we can get them both charged.
Well, that we need to discuss.
Yeah, come in. Ah, Philip. You finally got rid of them all, have you?
Well, sir, there's been a slight change of plan.
What are you doing?
I won't make a statement. Neither Verner nor Singh.
I thought Crewe and Hargood were trying to take their heads off.
Crewe and Hargood will say they're only demonstrating, Sarge. Allowed by the police to demonstrate about the delay in rehousing.
Mr. Verner, he's saying his car was only an old banger.
And Mr. Singh is sitting on a wafer-thin majority on the Cockcroft ward, apparently. So he doesn't want to be seen to be prosecuting voters instead of doing something about the estate.
Well, that's just about going to make Mr. Cato's day, in spades.
Yeah.
I mean, we're going to bung Crewe and Hargood back on the streets thinking they've made right prats of us. No, correction, knowing they've made right prats of us.
and leaving Mr. Cato cock of the hoop. I just sent Polly up to tell him.
Did you? Well, I think you'd better get up there yourself.
How do you mean?
I mean, all we can do is charge them with threatening behaviour or something. They're still going to be out of here. And when they are, and Mr. Cato finds out the councillor isn't complaining, he's going to come down on you two like a ton of bricks.
What happened?
He went ape, Tony. He said he was considering what disciplinary action to take for disobeying orders. What am I going to do if he puts that on my record?
No, don't you worry.
He said he squared it with Brownlow that we didn't run the demo properly and it was our fault the incident happened in the first place.
What?
He's turned the whole thing round, made it look as though we endangered the councillor.
Has he now?
Come in. Stamp, I was going to call for you.
Oh, yes, sir.
I've been considering your behaviour this morning. I think it amounts to gross insubordination.
Do you, sir? Am I right in presuming that this is a hats-off conversation? Person to person? Informal?
No, you are not.
OK, sir. So we'll keep it official. It's all in my notebook anyway. Inform CAD of the presence of Danny Hargood. Inform CAD of the presence of Derek Crewe. Inform CAD of the racial aspect of the protest. Recommended that the demonstration should not take place. But despite that, was ordered to keep a low profile at the protest, and thus allowing an assault on a councillor to occur. Did you tell Mr. Brownlow that, sir?
Now listen, Stamp, I
have... I had a decision taken away from me, sir, which is fine. But if I or Polly are to get into trouble for that, then this is not the last you'll hear of it.
Are you threatening me?
No, sir.
Perhaps we should make this an informal conversation after all. No hats, no ranks.
All right, then.
Good. Because we could start with your failure to find out Mr. Singh was a councillor, and your failure to tell me, and ignoring my radio signals, and lying about Singh and Verna wanting to press charges, and finally, your gross insubordination to me in front of Paige downstairs. Do I have a point or what?
Sir, everybody warned you about Hargood and Crewe, and you told us to stick it, in preference for getting one up with the Cockcroft.
In preference for good community relations.
Call it what you want, sir.
I will.
But it could have been a duff decision, couldn't it, sir?
It could have been. On that we might agree.
Oh, Philip.
Yes, sir.
Could we have that word now, or are you still busy with your familiarisation process?
No, sir, now I'll be fine. I think A relief and me are quite familiar enough now. Aren't we, Tony?
We are, sir.
Quite familiar.